Let's look at high pass filter in terms of its application in numbers and frequency. And we know high pass filter have this following form from the previous example. So tau s is minus 2cs plus divided by r1c1s plus 1. This case we don't have. Okay, for the sake of discussion, let's say if this one, this transfer function give you a body plot like this, let's not use the same. High pass filter, you have that high frequency pass and low frequency attenuate low frequency components. So let's continue in terms of this one. Let's make this value right here. Let's make it 20. Let's see right here is 10. Is our omega c. In other words, from here showing a high pass filter characteristic. Now let's look at numbers. Why, if my input in terms of sine t plus sine 100 t plus sine 1000 t, what would be the steady state output? Again, we can do sinusoidal in, sinusoidal out. We can do each individual signal here, or we can look at from high pass filter point of view, and then that means one would be about here. Let's make it 1 here. If that's the case, that should be 0 dB here. So 100 should be here. 1000 should be here. So this is in 20 in dB in body plot. So this value here, 20, is take 20 log of the amplitude ratio or magnitude of the sinusoidal transfer function. In other words, along this frequency range, high frequency above 10, the amplitude or magnitude of this sinusoidal transfer function will be, this is 1, 10 to the 1 should be 10 in linear scale. So meaning from here above 10, the amplification will be always 10. Below 10, every 10 less from 1 to positive, 1 to 10, 10 times of frequency, we have positive 20 dB per decade. That means my steady state output would be 0 dB, that's 1 times sine t at 100 frequency. 100, I have 20 dB, which is 10. So 1 times 10, so that's 10 times. With a phase, I forgot to put a phase, should be phase here. And then for 1000 should be 1 times 10 sine 1000 t plus 3.